It's about 5:40 or so on January the 15th, 2021. I just wanted to capture this incredible event that happened today. Excuse me. Sinus issues from being outside too much. We'll catch up with you. Caused me to do my normal winter time and anytime I get cool event. I'll start coughing. But anyway, started out this morning and I saw a number that God has shown me back in January of last year. So it's almost been a year. In a couple of more weeks, it'll be about almost a year since he first showed me a number called, it's 748. And basically what that is about is a page number in my Bible that speaks about Nehemiah chapter 5. It's actually just about everything of that's in chapter 5 of Nehemiah, where it talks about the farmers are mortgaged to the hilt. They've even sold their daughters because of their debt. That Nehemiah went to the nobles and officials and told them to give back all the interest, because they shouldn't have been charging all of the interest. Well, we finished our last grow out several weeks ago now, and the mortgage company wouldn't release the funds that should be our portion. And they've just put us in a real big bind of not even, to the point we couldn't even grow chickens over the last, or get more chickens put back on the farm the last couple of weeks. But, we had talked to an attorney to see if there was anything to do, and he wanted to see the paperwork that authorized the mortgage company to be on the check with the company name. I couldn't put my hands on it, but we went to the integrator, which is Ingram, and they provided the documents that were needed. And as soon as I looked at it, there's two, one for part of the farm and the other for the other part of the farm. Well, as soon as I looked at it, I saw that one of the forms was not properly signed. my dad, which owns the company, he had signed it. The lender had signed both documents, but the owner of the owner of Ingram had signed one but not the other. And I knew immediately this is the way God was going to work around this for us. And it was just a matter of waiting patiently to allow everything to fall into place. Oh gosh, that was back, checks were dated, I believe, December the 16th or something. So today is roughly a month later. After talking to, the same attorney yesterday morning, and he confirmed that the mortgage company has no right to be on that check. They do the other one because it was signed by everybody. But this one, yeah, he said they don't. Well, I took all of that after speaking with him up to the integrator yesterday. And the person that I talked to was the only one I knew to talk to. And he basically said, I'm not the owner, so we'll just have to see what the owner says. And so forth. So today, within 1 minute of each other, I saw 7:48. And I'm going, man, is this the day that I'm going to find out about that check or not? And I went on about my day. This was at 7:48 when I saw it. It was the time. Well, I go on about my day doing what I need to do. And did what God felt like, or I felt like what God was instructing me to do. This morning, and then got in the vehicle to go down the road, and I hadn't been on the road but just a few minutes, and I'm passing a Suburban or something like that that had 7:48 on the tag. And I took this picture at 12:40. Well, I didn't notice until quite a little while later that the guy that I talked to yesterday at the integrator, which is Ingram, had called me. And his phone call was at 12:51. And he said, when I called him back, now mind you, I saw the third 7:48 today at 12:40. He calls at 12:51. That's 11 minutes after God shows me 7:48. Absolutely astonishing. And call him back, and he says, "Got your check ready." And I'm going, oh my gosh. So I started looking up when I took that picture, the 7:48, when he called, and it was 11 minutes before he had made that phone call saying the check was done. So I get the check, and the first thing that I see is a 420. I'm gonna look that up because I want to make sure that I get it right. Excuse me. That's Romans 4:20. All right. Then it says, this. Get to it. Romans 4:20. Abraham never wavered in believing God's promise. In fact, his faith grew stronger in this. He brought glory to God. Guys, how amazing is that? As soon as I pick up the check, God shows me a 420, which is Romans 4:20 that I just read. And like 2 minutes later, I see the number 649, which is Psalms 64, verse 9. And I'm reading this out of my Bible here, guys. So bear with me. Excuse me. In Psalm 64, 9, says this: "Then everyone will be afraid. They will proclaim the mighty acts of God and realize all the amazing things he does." And I'm just going, man, what timing is all of that? And how unbelievable God is. in the timing, his perfect timing, just giving me a little bit of "I'm with you, son" things, you know. It's unbelievable, you know. And I'm sitting here thinking about all of this, you know. And and I you know, I get gas after going and taking care of that check. I get gas in the amount of gallons that I get is 9.81 gallons, I believe, and that's Psalms 98:1. "Sing a new song to the Lord, for he has done wonderful deeds. His right hand has won a mighty victory. His holy arm has shown his saving power." My goodness, guys. It's just so amazing that God shows out through my so unspecial life in ways that I can't even imagine why. You know, it's just absolutely incredibly cool. And so bizarre. But at the same time, makes my walk with the Father so peaceful to know that He's right there by my side and watching every step, you know, that I make. And there's one more, actually two more things as I'm making a note about this in the on my phone. I see 7. I'm sorry. I see 3:17. Sorry, I'm going to try to get to it quickly because I know this video is getting long. Alright. That is Ezekiel 3:17. And that says this. Is it? Son of man, I have appointed you as a watchman for Israel. Whenever you receive a message from me, warn the people immediately. When I saw that a while ago, as I was making a note about the timing of seeing the third 7:48 and the timing of the phone call 11 minutes later, I see 3:17, which is what I just read. So I knew that I needed to sit down and make a video of this unbelievable event and all that is just blowing my mind even right now as I sit here. You know, it's just really hard to understand sometimes. Let me show you. I'll read the last thing on that same screen that I saw the recent excuse me, it's 3:17. There's a 5:13, which is 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 13. And this is just so funny to me. And it reads, if it seems we are crazy, it is to bring glory to God. And if we are in our right minds, it is to benefit. It is for your benefit. Guys, I know it may seem kooky that God shows me numbers. That point me to either a page number or a Bible verse that he's probably already shown me, but he shows me new things all the time as well. But I just find it so amazing that He gives me these simple, just numbers, you know. Why He chose to do that, all I can say is that I manage a poultry farm, and that I see these numbers all the time, and it helps me, you know, when I have thoughts through the day, or I'm praying about something, you know. Just know that God is there with me. You know, sometimes I'll just break down and just start crying because, you know, just like today, I knew God was wanting me to do something even though it was so painful to do. I knew that He was telling me to do it. You know. And it may cost me something in the long run, I'm willing to sacrifice that cost and never stop telling people about Jesus in the way God wants to have a relationship with each one of the people that are his children. You know, and the more people I talk to about it, the more I get rejected about it. You know, some people get it, but most of the time, people don't understand, or they don't want to understand. I don't know what the case is. You know, and it's just really, really hard to swallow that sometimes, when you know that 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 God speaks to you in a just a very unusual way. Gosh, man. I guess I could just keep going on and on and on about how amazing it is. You know, and I've just shared just a few things. After receiving that check today, but I bet you it was, it was 10, 15 numbers of different Bible verses that God has shown me already, that just confirmed over and over and over and over and over. I mean, it was like one after another after another after another after another. I'm going, oh my gosh, God, I got it. I got it. But I think a lot of it has to do with he's wanting me to help someone be able to know this as well.